don't need to get your jacket, we're going.
No, just one.
All right, so we just got invited to his house.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Lucas, ты адрес знаешь?
Okay, some drinks. Wow,
we met some interesting characters.
Uh-huh.
And he's gone to buy vodka. And said, come to our apartment for some vodka. Oh my God, I think this night's going to get a little bit hardcore.
Uh-huh.
But can you handle it, Johnny?
Можно пить. Можно пить. All right. Поехала.
Where are we going?
We're going to our friend home.
Okay. Okay.
His name is Tadosh.
Okay.
Ex-criminal.
Okay.
So we're going there.
Okay.
He's very into Soviet things.
Okay. Cool. Interesting to me.
Yeah. So.
Wow. Johnny.
So you're gonna see some.
Johnny, can you behave yourself when we go to Tadeusz's house? Because Tadeusz is a serious man.
Uh-huh.
And if you knock something off the table and break it,
uh-huh,
because you're drunk, well,
you'll pay for it, thank you.
You'll pay for it with your legs. So be nice.
Okay, only 4 more beers then. And 3 about this.
Oh my God. Wow. Okay. This is the real adventure.
You realise that we're hanging out with Gibbon. Now, Gibbon ain't a man to be messing around with. This guy is someone who lived through the 80s and the 90s, served in Soviet prisons and Lithuanian prisons. This guy's a serious dude. Please don't knock anything off his fucking table, because we'll be paying with our bones, okay? Keep it cool. Let's not get killed. Let's have a nice evening.
Bald, why the heck did you say yes then? We could have just said no instead of the kebab shop.
Listen, when one of the toughest bloody criminals uh-huh. in all of Vilnius, allegedly,
uh-huh.
says...
Not allegedly, he went to prison for it.
Says, come to my house and drink vodka with me.
Uh-huh.
You don't refuse. You say, yes, Gibbon, I'm coming to your house to drink vodka with you. We make our excuses nicely after a couple of drinks and we leave with our legs intact.
I better be getting more than my $7 day rate for this. To keep you safe. Oh God.
Давай, давай, это можем рассказать, конечно. Давай, давай, расскажем это. Им интересно может быть. Давай, хорошо. Хорошо, давай. Он хочет. He wants to show you his old gang's pictures.
Yeah.
And explain what was, because the gang where he was involved was the biggest in Lithuania. More involved with politics, and okay. The main guy got death sentence. The last person in Lithuania who got that death person, it was him.
Was in his gang.
Yeah, yeah. He was right. The gang leader. Oh, and right. The end of criminal things in Lithuania was when they shot that guy.
And that was kind of like
going to the bottom. You
when
know?
Do you think that was? What year would that have been?
94, 95, right. Something like this, or right. Maybe 97.
Yeah. Yeah.
I might be, you know, wrong with the numbers.
Out.
Yeah, but they killed a journalist.
Okay.
And because of that, the government said that's the last thing, and they broke down the gang. Wow. And the thing why he was not in jail, the guy we were going to, he's always loved to drink.
Okay.
And the thing was that he was always completely drunk. And the day when they were planning the murder, there were 6 of them.
Right.
He was completely drunk and passed out. And the 4 guys planned it. Right. And one of the guys who was in the gang, he was undercover cop.
Okay.
So he saw that he didn't...
His drunkenness.
Yeah.
Wow.
And that's why he's not in the jail.
So listen, kids, be alcoholics and you'll stay out of prison.
Yeah.
Wow. That's amazing.
That's crazy. Yeah.
We're a lucky guy.
After he done some years in prison for small things, but he
avoided
managed,
the big sentence.
Yeah, the big thing.
Oh, lucky guy.
Because other guys got 13, 14 years in a prison. Other one got life sentence.
So he's still inside now?
No.
They let him go.
After 25 years, he got, from the president, he got like, you know...
Pardoned.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh.
So yeah.
Interesting history here in Vilnius.
Yeah, uh-huh. Big stories.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Здесь можно? Можно здесь заставить? Ну давай.
Young kids always writing name and then loch внизу.
Oh, loch.
Loch,
что лох? Что лохо?
Лох, это... this is like... I don't know how to explain it. Maybe...
Что
значит лох? Ты знаешь?
Slow?
Would you have it?
Лох, maybe...
It's fun. We're over 400 kilograms.
Здравствуйте, здравствуйте, спасибо большое, спасибо большое.
Да, у нас такой эклектик, хорошо. Не
обращайте
внимания. Подожди, вы скажите, что надо сделать.
We were too heavy for this elevator.
Ah, okay, so you need to have
two elevators, yeah.
We have Lenin.
Oh, let's wait for Bold, he'll enjoy this.
The place where we were at.
Guys, can you believe?
Where did we make progress? Bikes and stuff, people drinking beer and stuff.
Sometimes you can get, but you know, you can solve it really fast because the people who are working there, they're those type of guys who can solve their problems.
Here we are. Thank
you. Здравствуйте.
Привет, привет. Интересно. Окей,
здравствуйте. Ангельском. Подожди.
Ну, он не держит.
Спасибо большое.
Не мешает. Тебе не берется, чего?
Сделал бы без блэшку.
Ты он дочь? Are you their daughter?
No.
Oh. Okay,
friend's
friend. Okay. Okay. You could be their daughter.
Спасибо.
На здоровье.
Спасибо.
Короче, никто меня не слушает. Ну ладно. Это просто сам факт. Нет, сам факт.
Нет, это хороший напиток. Это самый хороший.
Ага,
сам.
Это здоровый.
Я с Ланитовским на виду 50 градусов даже.
Я слабый англичанин.
Да?
Слабый
англичанин.
So, we are drinking brandy.
Это бренди или коньяк? Это бренди.
Настойка.
Настойка.
На травах. На травах. Okay. It's like similar then to... Тоже бренди, тоже... Cognac, similar. Lithuanian brandy cognac. It's nice though. Oh, here's where the weapons are.
Это флаг, это оригинальный. Это флаг Литовской Республики Советской. Ему подарили, он его держит, я ему не разрешаю вывесить.
У нас нельзя, он сейчас запрещен.
Да.
Это запрещен? Да, запрещен. Это было, когда советская власть была,
он не сам был лигу по обеим полам.
О, вау. Нет, переверни.
Это другой стороны. Ну,
это настоящий старый
флаг? Да, настоящий старый флаг. Ну это просто, как коллекции можно держать и все. Это бывший флаг Литовской ССР. Вот, это вот был герб,
да,
а вот это флаг, вот посмотри. Посмотри вот сюда.
А, я видел. А, вот.
Так это был вот такой флаг, вот видишь?
Ему подарили, он вывесить не может. Он бы хотел бы, но не может. Дома, да?
Wait, show me.
This is the illegal flag. This was the flag of the Soviet Republic of Lithuania. It's illegal to show this flag now in Lithuania because we're post-Soviet. But Gibbon has it in his apartment here, hidden in the sofa.
Wow.
It's all in there, yes, no.
Ну я думаю, что главное, чтобы меня не расстреляли. Да. Когда если вы покажете, слушай, вот это мой фильм.
Да, вообще нет.
Ну на память будет, скажи, был от советской Литвы осталось. Слушай, это редкость, такой не найдешь. Помни,
я понял.
Пожалуйста. Подарок.
Не, как
да,
это
нет,
я слушаю, возьми, тебе подарок. Пускай будет, это на память.
Честно?
Да, честно.
Да.
Спасибо.
Не, спасибо большое. Спасибо за сосед.
Да.
Честно? Честно? Ну думала, честно, как... ну конечно, ну так что?
Не, я только думала, кому.
Мы за слова отвечаем.
Я думаю, это сохранит мой дом.
Ну.
Спасибо.
Все, представьте.
Well, if I get shown with this, I'm in big trouble, but this is a piece of Soviet history. This is a piece of Soviet history. Thank you for the present.
Wow.
Guys, I don't think you guys understand how crazy this is. This flag is completely illegal to even buy or even show in Lithuania. And it was gifted to Bald by one of the biggest gangsters of the 90s here in Lithuania.
Ну, в Англии
могу.
Да,
в Англии ты можешь делать все, что
делаешь. In England, I can show it, and I won't be in trouble.
Vaughn, what did you get us into? I thought we were just going to go have kebabs.
You never know where you're going to end up when you start drinking Lithuania.
I know. Just to let you know, if he gets mad,
he's not
just giving away everything.
Yes, mommy.
The weakling gets the Riesling.
Hey, I've been on it all day.
Oh, what an interesting place.
Uh-huh. Спасибо большое.
I mean, Moscow.
Красная площадь. Here, Vilnius. I never knew there was a Красная площадь.
Да, это интересно, это очень, слушай, такие времена были тяжелые.
Это интересно.
Конечно, интересно.
За вас, мальчик.
Во-первых, долго рассказывать, это мы так вот быстро, чтобы перелистать, посмотреть фотки, ну так это что.
А как вы помните это время? Это было хорошее время в вашей жизни или это было тяжело?
Ну как?
Это было самое замечательное
время. Да, я не сказал, что это начнется. Да, сейчас начнется. Сколько это было? А сколько это было? А сколько это было?
Сейчас будет начинать говорить. Понятно. Окей, so Gibbon's going to show us some photos from the 1990s.
Слушай, ну времена были такие тяжелые, но ты сам понимаешь, в 90-х они везде были тяжелые.
It was a tough time in the 90s. He wants to show us some pictures of his time and see how it was back then.
Mm, wow. Yes, no.
Yeah, oh, you're
the main guy. What is no,
the main guy, the boss.
Это Игорь Тёмкин.
Хорошо, понятно. No. Это где?
Уже в живых их нету. Этого расстреляли, а этого убили.
He was shot by the government and he was killed.
Wow.
Так. Леня Садовский. Ну, это все с Винницкой бригады. Миша,
basically, we're looking at pictures and photos of the criminal... you could say the criminal bosses of Lithuania in the 1990s.
Тут тоже уже почти в живых никого нету.
А это Рига еду. Это
Юрмала.
Да, Юрмала. Да. Понятно.
Ну это ерунда. Сейчас я вам подберу еще каких-то тут фотографий. Ну это.
Это было Гибон. Это было это время страх для вас тоже, я думаю.
Ну конечно. Слушай, воевали между собой. Ну вот тоже вот это вот Юрмала 92. Ну это вот эти года вот видишь. Вот я вижу, мы еще молодые.
Вау, блин. These were basically the toughest guys in Lithuania back in the day.
Это вот Словения такой сидел за убийство Лингиса. У нас такого журналиста знаменитого убили.
He was sitting in prison because...
За что Борьку расстреляли? Ну, Деканидзе расстреляли. Вот он 15 лет отсидел. Сейчас в Испании живет.
He killed Дженнис.
Интересно. Ну, это вот наши тусовки в Литве на 22-м.
Yeah, they all celebrated different places. Wow. И все были боятся вам, я думаю, ваша группа.
Было такое время, ну, слушай, ну.
These were different times. These were Soviet, post-Soviet times when people had to make money. There was no money, and they had the time of bandit capitalism. And basically, they were racketeering, and like people had to pay if you had a cafe or a shop or a restaurant or whatever a business, you had to pay money to people like this to keep open.
I mean, wow.
Tough times.
Literally him.
Literally, literally, literally. Yeah.
Вот я. Это молодой 19...
It's from newspaper. Mafia changed their face. Called Mafia Keičeraida.
This is Gibon in a local newspaper from 1999.
Mafia changed their face.
Wow. Это си.
Пожалуйста, ви.
Это ви, это ви. Извините, извините, извините.
Во, Бонька здесь еще живой. Это 91 год, наверное,
какой-то. Так интересно.
Гадание не помню.
Так хорошо, что у вас есть так много фотки из этого времени.
Ну вот видите.
Точно можно. Да, да.
Вот он.
Это был босс.
Да, это босс.
Понятно. Вау, так много истории.
Yeah.
А, это зона, 89-й год.
Зона, значит, что? Это была
тюрьма? Да, провинишки.
This was in the prison when he was serving his time for his crimes. При СССР.
Да, СССР, 89-й год это был.
This was a logging camp in a prison
where... Да, я тебе скажу, сейчас покажу, где я. Я тебе покажу, это лесоповал на лесобирже мы. Сейчас, это наша кентовка, нахуй. Ну вот. Сейчас я тебе покажу. А, вот я. Вот видишь, запретка. Вот видишь, какие зоны. Вот это я.
Wow, look, you can see the barbed wire.
Вот я, вот я, see, молодой. Wow. Это 89-й год. Мне 22 года было. Ой,
22 years old. Already in prison for his activities. Wow. Да, вижу.
Молодые мы были нормальные.
Подключенная зона. Да, 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 да. Look how big they are, he's saying. Like they were training out in that camp. Wow.
Yeah. When we went to this kebab shop today, I had no idea we would end up in the apartment of one of the most hardened ex-criminals of Lithuania, having a show us memory photos from down memory lane. I used to watch both videos. How does he get in these situations, like invited over to people's houses for vodka or drinks? Here we are. It shows that any of you watching this might end up in this situation sooner than later.
We have Gibon with the in school when it started with Lenin behind him, real Soviet photo.
Oh, wow. And now you have Lenin behind you somewhere.
Yeah, Lenin's still here somewhere. Nothing's changed.
No mana.
Ну, это тут какие-то семейные. А, это я боксирую, боксом занимался, это я не знаю. Это в Бресте на сборах.
Oh, only the tallest, biggest guy.
Yeah.
You chose the biggest, strongest guy.
There are some people who
don't like him. Well, I think people just who don't know him.
Mm.
But they don't. The most who knows, they like him.
Or they are dead.
If you call him at night, he will go and help you. Okay. Mm. It's this
loyal.
Type
loyalty.
Of absolutely.
Absolute.
Если был ситуация, вы подошел мне 90 когда-то, у меня есть кафе. И вы мне сказали, Бенджамин, ну как это вы сделали, когда крыша? Надо сказать, Бен, дай мне сразу деньги, или как мы будем это обсуждать, эта ситуация? Потому что я не хочу платить, вы хотите деньги, как мы будем обсуждать?
Ну, значит, я как бы, слушай, какое-нибудь давление было психологическое, если не помогло бы, было бы какое-нибудь, ну, другое, может, все пришлось бы платить.
Это я уже понял.
Такое, значит, бывает такое скрытое насилие, как японцы говорят, или кто. Ну, вроде бы ты нам ничего не должен.
Я буду платить все равно.
Да.
Давайте бухаем тогда за это. I was asking Gibbon.
Понятно, ну, не со всех брали.
I was saying in the 1990s, if I had a cafe and... Gibbon, his gang came to me and said, like, listen, you owe us some money, and I didn't really want to pay. Like, how do we sort that situation out? And he said, listen, doesn't matter what I said, you would end up paying in the end.
It was the time.
Different times.
Yes, different times. Yes.
Yeah, 90s. Yeah, it's not now.
Yeah.
Of course, no, I understand.
Not now. Now it's like, you know, everybody will say, yeah, you're crazy.
Yeah, yes.
Sure. Sure.
It was understandable. Yeah.
So when did this time end, would you say? Which year was it, when you joined the EU or before? When would you say that this time of... When would you say it ended?
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's not about them, it's about government.
Okay.
Because when it starts to be, you know, police start to be loyal, when you not pay to police anymore,
yep.
It's like, and every, yeah, it's become, you know, you not pay to police, two people think that he's have some power.
Of course. And that will always
for
be
some reason. But you know about my husband, because he don't understand English. We was walking around city, and it was like 10 guys from Switzerland, and we was walking, they was speaking, because I speak English, and everybody was looking at us, and he say, oh, they recognized me. And I say, maybe I'm just pretty woman.
No.
And he said, no. No, it's because of him. And I say, they don't know you, this from. He will go and help you.
You know,
doesn't matter. It's a good person by the Bible, you know.
Yeah. You know what, Anastasia? What I think? That even from when Gibbon was in the 90s, like, people just think bad people, criminals.
No.
But I think it was only when there was some situation that he had to be, but when he was with his friends or family, it's not like just anybody he would attack or take money from. I think people still had morals back in those days.
Absolutely.
But they also had to make some money somehow.
You know, when in back 2000, when he went to jail, 2012?
Oh, it was later that, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It was not recently, for 3 years, it was some bad situation, doesn't matter. And I was so surprised that people that I don't know was calling me and telling me, I want to give you money to send to him. I didn't even know these people, what it says about person. Why you, for example, want to give money for some person? I don't know what these people are. They from, I don't know, 10, 20 years ago.
Probably it means a lot.
Yeah,
it means a lot.
A good heart,
yes.
A good soul.
Absolutely.
Interesting. Wow.
Yeah.
What do you think the average Lithuanian citizen would say if they saw us talking together? Would they say, "Oh, be careful, that's a bad man"? Or what do you think they would say?
I think because in the it's a new style, because we have, you know, I not him, but I do Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
And TikTok for fun.
Yeah.
And I think new generation like to know about the past.
Yeah.
He don't even understand what we're talking about. And a lot of young people like him. Without, sure. I don't know.
Это что-то крутое, я
думаю. Я думаю
да,
тоже, да.
Да. Да.
Только я знаю, какой он подлец. Но это между нами. Она, знаешь, мы встаем утром, кто кофе рассыпал, кто...
My life isn't so interesting.
TikTok, we don't have TikTok. Near YouTube.
YouTube.
Ben TikTok. Stop at TikTok.
I don't know.
It happened just by chance, like everything in life. Just you
fall into
something.
What you doing before?
Nothing interesting. You could say this. And then just somehow fell into this YouTube thing, and here I am, 3 years later, in your apartment.
Yeah,
having a nice conversation with you. This is where it's come to after 3 years.
No. That invite whole fucking Russia 300 years ago.
Uh-huh.
So I understand why people.
Потом Чингис
Хан. Yeah. Yes, but he's absolutely kind person. You know that you see him and you understand that. Oh, Yeah. You should be, you know, you should be the nice to this.
What's your
Как это называется?
Yeah. Okay, but to here.
Mongolia plus USA.
Yeah, that's mixed.
Yeah. Do you know how to ride a horse?
Yes.
You look like a Mongolian.
You look like a soldier. No, I'm just saying that it's like Chechen, like Mongolian, right now, if anybody tries to break into this apartment, they will be dead because we will for sure protect each other. Now,
this is to taking care of each other and making sure everyone is safe. How do you say
it? So we are safe, yeah?
It's not good, it's not only fine, it's a criminal offense, how we call it.
Yeah, criminal offense.
Criminal offense.
To show these symbols of Soviet past and things like this.
But I think it's Serb and Molot, and SSSR, I don't think.
Ну, китайский символ не запрещен, а советский запрещен. Ну,
ты знаешь, коллекционер, у него огромная коллекция, у него какие-то там BC, какие-то там у него статуэтки. Да. У него самое главное, вот in France, что он имел, и приехали к нам.
Спасибо огромное, что пригласили нам.
Спасибо огромное, что приехали.
И спасибо за подарки.
Но я до сих пор не понимаю, а почему решили заниматься этим?
У меня был бизнес. Как говорит на русском, садник, человек, который делает сад.
Гарденер.
У меня был бизнес 15 лет, да? 14 лет, 13 лет. И надо представлять, что это был новость каждый день. Советский пресс СССР, наши враги. Они плохие, это очень плохое место.
И это было на меня удивлено. Да, люди нормально, люди хорошие.
Что это значит? Как выживаете?
Ты еще не видел, как я пью.
Не надо, чтобы они видели. Один уже лежит, вот. Хорошо, как?
Ба-ба-ба!
А вот ребята...
растерял. Ра-ра-ра-ра-ра.